Hi, I'm Pascal, and I'm currently having troubles with this piezoelectric measuring chain. It is showing a massive drift. Are you curious on how to troubleshoot and identify the drifting component? If so, let me show you on how to troubleshoot in a systematic way. First of all, let me introduce you into this piezoelectric measuring chain. A piezoelectric force sensor is connected to the charge amplifier through a high-insulating cable. The charge amplifier converts the charge signal of the force sensor into a voltage signal and in this case digitizes the signal directly in the charge amplifier. The digitized signal is transferred to this PC via Ethernet connection for visualization of the signal. Before starting with the troubleshooting, it is important to dismount the sensor from the process fixture. This is required to ensure the sensor is not under load and process parameters have no influence on the measured signal. With this measuring chain here, the sensor is freestanding and no force is applied to the sensor. Therefore, we expect a force signal around 0 Newton. Let's have a look at the currently measured force signal and see if we get what we expect. I start the measurement to check the signal. The force signal has a massive drift and is definitely not what we expect. So the question is, where is the drift originating from? The troubleshooting approach to identify the drifting component is from sensor to the charge amplifier. By disconnecting one component after each other and checking the measurement signal after every single step, we can identify the drifting component. Let's start with the sensor and disconnect it from the measuring chain. Since no sensor is connected, we expect to measure a signal around 0 Newton. I start the measurement to check how the signal looks now. The signal still shows the same massive drift. Therefore, it is clear that the drift is not caused by the sensor. The drift must originate from either the cable or the charge amplifier. Let's proceed with the next component and disconnect the high-insulating cable. Again, since no sensor is connected, we expect to measure 0 Newton. I start the measurement and check how the signal looks now. This looks great and is the signal we expect. No drift is visible and the signal is around 0 Newton. So the high insulating cable must be the drifting component. Let's replace the cable by a new one and check if we got rid of the massive drift. I connect the sensor again to have the full measuring chain available and start the measurement. The signal looks great. It seems we have fixed the measuring chain and got rid of the massive drift. That was pretty quick and easy, wasn't it? Of course, there are other cases where troubleshooting might not be so straightforward. In such cases, our experienced service engineers will be very happy to help you. I hope this video was helpful for you, and I'll catch you in another one.